Welcome to another session. Today, my topic of discussion is glycolysis. Glycolysis is the first part of respiration where carbohydrates are converted into pyruvic acid. The formation of pyruvic acid from carbohydrates through glycolysis is the same and common in both aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Respiration is a complex biological process where complex compounds are oxidized into simpler compound and energy is released. Respiration is mainly of two types. The first one is aerobic respiration and the second one is anaerobic respiration. The aerobic respiration occurs in all living cells of higher plants. It requires oxygen. The end products of aerobic respirations are carbon dioxide and water. In aerobic respiration, one molecule of glucose produces 38 ATP molecules through oxidation. Here, the organic compounds are completely oxidized and thus high energy is released. The aerobic respiration reactions, except the glycolysis, takes place inside the mitochondria of a cell. Whereas the anaerobic respiration occurs in bacteria, certain fungi, germinating seeds and fleshy fruits. Oxygen is not required in anaerobic respiration. The end product of anaerobic respirations are alcohol and carbon dioxide. In anaerobic respiration, only 2 ATP molecules are produced. Here, the organic compounds are incompletely oxidized and very small amount of energy is released. The process of anaerobic respiration occurs in cytoplasm. Now, the mechanism of respiration. The process of respiration is completed into two parts. In first part, the carbohydrates are converted into pyruvic acid, that is called glycolysis. And in the second part, pyruvic acid is oxidized into carbon dioxide and water and is called Krebs cycles. In aerobic and anaerobic respiration, the formation of pyruvic acid from carbohydrates through glycolysis is the same and common. But later on, the fate of pyruvic acid depends upon the presence and absence of oxygen. In the presence of oxygen, pyruvic acid is oxidized into carbon dioxide and water, whereas in absence of oxygen, pyruvic acid is oxidized into carbon dioxide and alcohol. Now, the glycolysis. Glycolysis is the metabolic process in which glucose converts into pyruvic acid. The metabolic pathway of glycolysis was firstly discovered by three German scientists, Emden, Meyerhoff and Parnas. On their names, the glycolysis is also called as EMP pathway. The process of glycolysis takes place in the cytoplasm of a cell. Through glycolysis, glucose is oxidized into pyruvic acid in presence of many enzymes and coenzymes present in the cytoplasm. There are 10 enzymes involved in the process of glycolysis. Oxygen is not required at any step of glycolysis. Glycolysis produces two molecules of each of pyruvic acid, ATP, NADH, and water. Now, the next one is glycolysis pathway. In general, the process of glycolysis accomplished in four major stages. The first stage is the synthesis of fructose 1,6-diphosphate takes place from glucose with the help of enzymes such as phosphohexokinase, phosphohexoisomerase, and phosphofructokinase. The second one is cleavage of fructose 1,6-diphosphate into 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde and dihydroacetone phosphate with the help of aldolase enzyme. The third one is oxidation of 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde into 3-phosphoglyceric acid with the help of enzymes diphosphoglyceraldehyde, dehydrogenase and फॉस्फोग्लिसरोकाइनेज. द फोर्थ वन इज द सिंथेसिस ऑफ पाइरुविक एसिड फ्रॉम 3-फॉस्फोग्लिसरिक एसिड इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द फॉस्फोग्लिसरो म्यूटेज एनोलेज एंड फॉस्फोपाइरुविक काइनेज एंजाइम्स. Now, the stage first of glycolysis pathway. In this stage, the synthesis of fructose 1,6-diphosphate takes place from glucose. In the first step, the phosphorylation of glucose molecule takes place, in which glucose molecule react with ATP to form glucose 6-phosphate and ADP in presence of an enzyme phosphohexokinase and cofactor magnesium ion. And here, ATP reduced into ADP, thus we can say the loss of one ATP molecules occur in this step. Now, in the second step, glucose 6-phosphate undergoes for isomerization in the presence of an enzyme phosphohexoisomerase to form fructose 6-phosphate, and it is a reversible reaction. And in the third step, further, the phosphorylation of fructose 6-phosphate takes place with the help of ATP, resulting into the formation of the fructose 1,6-diphosphate in the presence of the enzyme phosphofructokinase and magnesium ion as a cofactor. Thus, here ATP reduced into ADP, resulting the loss of one ATP molecules again. In the second stage of glycolysis pathway, the cleavage of fructose 1,6-diphosphate takes place into 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde and dihydroacetone phosphate. In the fourth step, the fructose 1,6-diphosphate, which is 6-carbon compound, now splits into 3-carbon compounds, 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde and dihydroacetone phosphate, with the help of the enzyme aldolase. These both compounds are called as triose phosphates and are interconverted into each other in the presence of an enzyme phosphotriose isomerase, so that the balance is maintained. In further reactions, two molecules of 3 carbons will be involved. 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde formed in stage 2 now enters into stage 3 of glycolysis pathway. In this stage, the oxidation of 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde takes place into 3-phosphoglyceric acid. In step 5, 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde react with phosphoric acid, resulting into the formation of 1,3-diphosphoglyceraldehyde. Now, in step 6, 1,3-diphosphoglyceraldehyde oxidized into 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid in the presence of an enzyme diphosphoglyceraldehyde dehydrogenase and a coenzyme NAD. During this reaction, two molecules of hydrogens are released to form diphosphoglyceraldehyde, which reduce NAD to NADH2. In the step 7, diphosphoglyceric acid loses one of its phosphate, which combines with ADP to form 3-phosphoglyceric acid and ATP in the presence of the enzyme phosphoglycerokinase. Thus, this step gains 2 ATP molecules. Now, 3-phosphoglyceric acid enters into stage 4 of glycolysis pathway. In this stage, the synthesis of pyruvic acid takes place from 3-phosphoglyceric acid. In step 8, an isomeric change takes place in 3-phosphoglyceric acids, resulting into transfer of phosphate from carbon 3 to carbon 2 and formation of 2-phosphoglyceric acid in the presence of the enzyme phosphoglyceromutase. In step 9, 2-phosphoglyceric acid loses two molecules of water in the presence of the enzyme enolase and is converted into phosphoenol pyruvic acid. And finally, in 10th step, now one phosphate group is removed from phosphoenol pyruvic acid with the production of pyruvic acid under influence of an enzyme. Phosphopyruvikinase and cofactor magnesium ion. The phosphate group is accepted by ADP to form ATP. Thus, this step is again is energy storing step where two molecules of ATP are gained. Now, the summary of glycolysis. In glycolysis, from one molecule of glucose, two molecules of pyruvic acids are formed. Four molecules of ATP are formed and two molecules of ATP are consumed in the glycolysis. Therefore, there is a net gain of two ATP molecules. Two molecules of NAD are reduced to two molecules of NADH2, which later on oxidized aerobically to yield six molecules of ATP. Thus, the energy of glucose becomes stored partly in ATP molecules and partly in NADH2 molecules. The oxygen is not required in the process of glycolysis and the carbon dioxide is also not produced. This is all about the glycolysis. If you have any queries and any doubt in your mind regarding to this lecture, you may write in the comment section. And thank you for watching this video.